You're listening to the Bearded Theologians podcast, hosted by Zach Bechtold and Matt Franks. If you'd like to learn more about the Bearded Theologians, you can go online at beardedtheologians.com, where we have past podcasts, blogs, and a couple of items for sale. So check us out, beardedtheologians.com. Thank you for listening, and enjoy this week's show. You're listening to the Bearded Theologians podcast, hosted by Matt Franks
and Zach Bechtold.
So this week, as we were trying to figure out what to talk about, we realized that we're halfway through Lent. And so we're going to do kind of like a midweek Lent or mid-Lent checkpoint. And so, Zach, as you think about that, what comes to mind?
Lent's one of those seasons, kind of like the beginning of, you know, January 1, right, where we... in the church, we make resolutions in a sense. It's a little more complicated than that, but we give something up, we take something on, we do something in preparation for Lent that hopefully causes us to grow and connect with God and connect with ourselves a little bit more. And I think sometimes we like a New Year's resolution, we get to the middle of Lent and go, oh, I haven't done the thing I said I was going to do. And, you know, we often, because we're human, feel some sort of guilt or shame or, you know, things like that. And I simply want to encourage you, that's okay. Whatever you're doing or not doing, or whatever you've tried to take on as a spiritual practice or give up in your life, and it hasn't gone perfectly, that's okay. I want to encourage you in that sense of Lent's not a time for us to be perfect. And if we don't achieve that perfection through Lent, it's okay. I just simply want to lift up that encouragement to that it's okay. And if whatever you're doing, even if you've only done it once and it made you feel good, feel that thing. Great. Hold on to that and let it bring you closer to yourself and closer to God.
I almost want to just like play devil's advocate and just go complete opposite and do like, no, you must submit to your Lenten discipline, and you must eat all the things on Saturday or Sunday night, or, you know, I don't know. No, I think like the hard part about when we get to this point in Lent, if we're truly following it, the question I've always asked, the question I'll ask and probably till I'm blue in the face will be, is, whatever our practice is, whatever our Lenten discipline is, how is it working with our connection with God? And if it has nothing to do with God, like if you decide to quit eating chocolate and it doesn't wreck your relationship with God, or if it doesn't like adjust your behavior towards God, like, is it worth, like, was it really worth the practice of Lent? You know, the practice of Lent is to recenter us, refocus us, renew us. And if our practice doesn't do those things, then you're not doing it. I mean, I'll honestly be real, like, you're not doing it right. Lent is supposed to be a season of recentering. I mean, repentance, like, is a big theme of Lent. And if we're not doing things that cause us to repent, I really would, encourage you to think about that. Like, how does your Lent, if you're still doing it, like, how does your Lent practice shape and guide your faith? And if you've forgotten about it, that's okay too. Like, I think Zach's okay, right? Like, that's okay too, but like, get back into something. Because you'll find some health there.
Right. And it's, I guess what I'm trying to rally against is the guilt and shame of, well, if you didn't do it perfectly, right. To whip yourself and flog yourself and, repent in those ways. Cause I think sometimes we do that. Well, you weren't perfect. You didn't do it right. You're not a good Christian, blah, blah, blah. When in reality, as long as we're striving, as long as we're trying, and we use those moments that it does click to ask that question, how is this bringing me closer? How is this strengthening my relationship, strengthening my faith? We have a leg forward over the top of, you know, the kind of common guilt and shame that's placed on top of it.
Lent, Advent, ordinary time, mm-hmm. like, the real question we have to ask is, like, are you the same person you were a year ago because of your faith? And if you're not, like, what can you do? You know, what are some practices you can do? And I'm, you know, I love spiritual practices. I mean, I Lectio Divina every day. I do sitting meditation periodically. I do a lot of those. The one I don't do, I hate journaling. I think journaling is like the worst thing ever because it brings up trauma from when I was a kid. So I don't mess with journaling. But I think having spiritual disciplines and spiritual practices are what get us through whatever it is we're going through. And, you know, I want to encourage you that if you're struggling with that, you know, seek a pastor, seek a spiritual director to help you, you know, with those things and discern what's a best practice for you. But don't let that be something that like that doesn't push you forward. Like, and right. I said this the other day that our, you know, I really do believe that our spiritual practices should renew us, but that doesn't mean we go back to who we are. It means that we move forward into the creation that God created us to be.
Right. And the thing that we get caught up in, Lynn, or just anytime we make any kind of resolution, we don't do the things that other people do if they don't work for you, right? Find the thing that works for you. Sitting and meditating, not a thing that I do well. Sitting and doing anything quietly is not a thing I do well. It doesn't connect me with anything. But being out about, talking to people, just being out in nature, those are my spiritual practices, right? And so find the thing that works for you. Because I can tell you, I spent, I don't know, way, way too many years thinking I had to do my faith and Christianity and practices like everyone else, and they just didn't work. They didn't bring me closer to anybody. But it was when I found the practices that I do helpful. They're different, you know? And so don't think that you have to do this Lent like everyone else. Like Matt said, find the thing that works for you and that connects you not only with yourself but with God, and see how that pushes your faith forward, or strengthens it, or how, whatever, right, whatever verb you want to put there, what works for you works for you, and really truly isn't anybody else's business but your own. And so find that thing, whether it's something you can do every day, whether it's something you do once a week, whatever, it doesn't matter. Find what works for you, and know that there's seasons, right? Right. Sometimes it'll be great, and other times it'll fall flat.
And okay, I think that I think that's important, is that it's your spiritual journey and it's not anyone else's. And so, like, if you see something, like if you know, someone was trying to get me to do something, and I was like, no, like, this is just not who I am. And like, well, you're not trying hard enough. Like, well, no, I am. I'm not the same person as you are. And like, recognizing what you're willing to do, what you're not willing to do, like, make your no be no, and don't really fall into that guilt of like having to do something that you don't feel like you can do. You know, there's nothing wrong with saying no. Like, that's something I was talking with my daughter about the other day, with something, is like, make your no be no, and like, hold on to that. And if they're not going to respect your no, you don't need to be their friend. And I think that that's the same thing. Like, you know, sometimes we say no. And I think there are times when we say no, we need to be pushed to say yes for a lot of things. Mm-hmm. But also know that if you're always saying no, then yeah, you probably need to maybe say yes every now and then, or the other way around. If you're always saying yes, maybe you need to say no every now and then too, to see, to help you free yourself up a little bit. Cause I think we overwhelm ourselves too much. And I think that's, so to kind of go back to what we were starting with, and like, let's kind of bring it full circle, is that's what happens in Lent. We get so tied up in everything else going on that we forget whatever our practice is, or we didn't really dive into it like we should because we weren't as invested in it as we needed to be, because we lost the importance of it, of what Lent really is. It's about a reconnection and reconfiguring ourselves to grow closer towards God.
Well, I think it's that. And I think it's also the mentality of, hey, I'm gonna run a half marathon, and you set out to run the half marathon and train for it, and you try to run, you know, 12, 13 miles on your very first run ever, it's not gonna work. You gotta start slow, you gotta run a mile. And work your way up into that distance. Lent and spiritual practices aren't anything different. If you say, hey, I'm gonna read the whole Bible through Lent, good luck. That's a lot.
I would really question your sanity at that point.
Exactly. But if you say, hey, I'm going to read through Matthew's gospel through Lent, that's a fair one. It's a fair enough bite to pull off in the time through Lent, but it also paces yourself to move on to the next thing. And so you've created a practice rather than I don't even know what to call it, but you know, you're running a mile instead of trying to run 13.
Well, and I think too, of course you like the running metaphors because you actually do like to run. I think running is the devil.
No, I don't like to run. But
yeah, right.
I don't want my heart to explode. So
it's going to explode either way. What does it matter? Once you live your life to the fullest.
That's right. But that's the thing is we try to dive in head first in the moment we hit that wall, and we, you know, it's way harder than we thought. It's easy to give up, and it's easy to justify that giving up because we bit off more than we could chew.
Well, it was like, okay, so for me, I just started walking. I know it sounds crazy. I just started walking last week, like literally removed crutches. And so yesterday when I was talking with my prayer group, and I was talking about like my legs are killing me and it hurts. And I was like, I want you to understand, like I just started walking again after not walking for 6 weeks. So I expected this. And so like, I think too, with Lent, like any other spiritual practice, we have to be willing, like there's going to be struggles along the way, and how we push through those struggles matters. And so like, I kind of want to wrap this up as we bring this to a close today, you know, like it's okay to be where you're at, but don't just settle for that and move forward and find ways that you can connect with God and really lean into, maybe you jump back to what your Lenten practice was. Maybe you've fallen short and maybe, you know, you need to jump in. And, you know, I know for like me, the hard part for me is like, you know, I'm committing to reading this devotional book and like I'm a couple of days behind. So maybe not catch up, but maybe just start over with the day. And like, that's kind of what I did this week. And I've really enjoyed it. I haven't feel like I've had to build upon it. But I've really enjoyed what I've read thus far. And like, I mean, I think that's like, it's okay to hit reset. And I think that's kind of where we're at, where it's okay to hit reset, but like, you know, please continue to practice and please continue to do what you need to do to enhance your faith. And, you know, we want to encourage you to check out our website at beardedtheologians.com. We've got a lot of great content up there. Pick up a shirt or two for Father's Day and all those holidays are coming. There's a lot of those kind of holidays coming up that'd be good for Bearded Theologians gear. Ordinations, what a great ordination gift would be a Bearded Theologians coffee mug. We've seen those pop up in some of those pastoral videos that you all are doing out there, and you know, feel free to continue to do that. And we want to thank you for listening, and don't forget to share us and like us and connect with us through the social medias. And so for the Bearded Theologians, I'm Matt Franks.
I'm Zach Bechtol. Thanks for checking us out.
First, guys, I want you to subscribe and like this video. And push that thumbs up.
Thank you for listening to the Bearded Theologians podcast. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share on all social media outlets. You can check out old episodes and more information at beardedtheologians.com. Thanks for checking us out.